The monumental awaits the above. The monumental will explain the nexus to thee.
Still alive?
I am impressed. This is something that might interest you. The black-robed maiden of the Nexus looks after the flames. She's a morose type, with eyes occluded by wax. She can control souls like no other. Bring her the souls of men and demons, and she will embolden your flesh and blood with their power. But beware. Do not devolve into a foul beast.
What's happened? Have you lost your nerve?
No matter. Have a seat. We can sit here forever. At least we will be safe.
The monumental awaits the above. The monumental will explain the nexus to thee.
I would be happy to lighten your load and look after any excess baggage. When the scourge came, I abandoned my wife and daughter and fled like a madman. When I came to, I was in the Nexus. I haven't dared venture outside these walls since. I wish I could do more, but I am ignorant of the world beyond these walls. That candle maiden cared for me during my first days in the Nexus. She says very little, but has a kind heart. She's just the age my young daughter would have been. The poor, poor girl, trapped here with her eyes occluded by wax. If only something could be done to help her. Rest assured, your goods are safe and sound with me. Best of luck to you. Wait, where are you going?
Oh, good day to you. I can forge weapons for you, for a fair price. Perhaps you've already heard, but there's another blacksmith at the entrance of Stonefang Mine. He's an eccentric old man, but he knows his trade well. He's the only sane one left in a town of soul-starved men. If you do meet him... Yeah, well, forget it. That stubborn old ne'er-do-well will just ignore you.
You come back alive. I need your business.
We have long awaited you, Slayer of Demons. I am one of the Monumentals. We preserve the fabric of reality. There is something thou needest to know. Once, we too, a scourge of demons faced. In the distant past, under a benevolent rule, the world was united. Owing to the soul arts. Until a lust for power caused the awakening of the Old One. Across the land seeped a colorless deep fog, and the world faced extinction at the hands of the demons. Thanks be, we were able to lull the Old One back to his slumber. Yet only after the loss of innumerable souls and half the world lost, erased by the fog. In order to mend the fabric of what land still remained, we entrusted six elders with six precious archstones. One to the king of a small yet diligent land. One to the king of the burrowers underground. One to the wise queen of the great ivory tower. One to the chieftain of lost and ill-fortuned souls. One to the shaman of the tempest-worshipping shadow men. And the last to the great giants of the northern lands. The archstones were placed at nodes across the earth. We contained the Old One inside this nexus and banned the soul arts. Finally, we became monumentals, half-living sentinels of the fabric of reality. Alas, The other monumentals have perished, and only I remain. Now it is your turn. You must lull the Old One back to its slumber and seal it away for all eternity. If not, the deep fog will absorb all that we know. Have you the strength to accept this mission? Yes, we are fortunate indeed to have you. Now, go forth and destroy every last demon. The Old One, without demons to feed its souls, will a new servant seek and lure you to its bosom.
Are you here to face the demons? If so, please free Sage Frake the Visionary from the Dungeon of Latria. I will help you however I can teach you elementary spells. Sage Frake is a gleaming hope for humankind, but I have not the power to save him alone. Be careful how you use it. Normally, it would not be granted to one such as yourself. I had to make an exception for the sake of Sage Frake.
Brave soul, who fears not death. Prithee, lull the Old One back to its ancient slumber. What is it? Dost thou seek soul power? So be it. After all, thou requirest strength. Go forth, touch the demon inside me. Let these ownerless souls become thine own. Soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended. Art thou done? May thine strength help the world be mended.
What was that? Best of luck.
I can f- Do come back alive.
Be another disciple of God. I too am on a quest to fight the demons in the name of the Lord. May I share God's power with you? Do not be bashful. We are both cut from the same cloth. See, I pray we meet again.
I have sinned. I swore allegiance to Saint Urbane, but was of no use to him. And now I have run away and abandoned his honorableness. O Lord, punish me, for I have not the strength to punish myself. O Honorable One, I hesitate to imagine your present state. Deep within the darkness, where no light shall ever shine. Will you continue to pray, even in such misery? O Honorable One, I hesitate.
Back in the time that I lived below Bolotaria Castle, King Aland left on some strange business, then returned with horrible demons in tow. Soon, the land was ravaged by demons and soul-starved madmen. My spine shudders just to think about it. If I did not have my miracle stone shard, a keepsake of my grandfather, I may not have survived. If I did not have my miracle stone shard, a keepsake...
Thou seekest soul power, then touch the demon and soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. Art thou done? May thine strength.
Are you begging for a magic lesson?
Thank you.
Be careful how you use it. Normally, it would not be granted to one such as yourself. I had to make an exception for the sake of Sage Frake.